What's up, guys? Man, I got a lot of things to actually talk about right now. I have Obafemi Martins deny his friend CDQ Iris Burnaboy beats up CDQ. That is something that a lot of people are now talking about. And I still have O'Malley shares crazy experience with female fan, and that is actually interesting. And you guys need to listen to that. Man, I still have this one. Love cycle remains. What should we expect from Davido and Enisa? And that is already trending on social media. A lot of people are talking about it, and I think it's all interesting to note. But before I jump right in, I want you guys to kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, hit the subscribe button below and the bell notification icon to always get notifications each time I upload my videos. But if already subscribed, thank you for subscribing, and make sure you share my videos across all social media platforms so that others will get to see what is trending and what we are talking about on social media. Alright guys, man, it's no news that a particular beef has been going on between Burnaboy and CDQ at the point in time, and it says something like CDQ once said that, man, Burnaboy had disrespected Obafemi Martins, and that is something that they can't take because he's a friend of Obafemi Martins. And then something came up, and CDQ actually said, man, Burnaboy did stab me in the last night and the rest. And then that video went viral on social media. Burnaboy has not said anything about that. And he said, yes, his crew and his friends, they did that to me, and but I did something to him also. And these kind of things, I should not expect it from the likes of CDQ, Burnaboy, and then, Obafemi Martins. But Obafemi Martins has come out to say, man, he has been hearing kind of allegations going around on social media. A lot of people have been making different kind of stories around that. That's something, is something that they've resolved so far, and everything has been put to rest, and everybody is good. And then Obafemi Martins went ahead to say, yes, that club was not open. According to him, said he is the one of the major shareholder of that club. And he did call his guys, like Burnaboy and other friends, just to kind of squash some things, and then squash some beef. And then a lot of people made it around on social media that yes, something is happening. That is according to what he posted on social media. And some people are now saying that yes, who is lying at this particular time? Burnaboy has not said anything about that. I think he is more focused on his Grammy Awards performances and nomination right now. Winning a Grammy Award is going to change a lot of things for Burnaboy, and I think that is what he is focused on. And according to a report that made around, is that Burnaboy actually borrowed CDQ some money, and which he never paid back and the rest, and that generated into a kind of rancor, which a lot of people are now talking about on social media. But you still got to understand that he went further. According to the report making around on social media, is that Burnaboy went further to say, if Martin is a big boy, Obafemi Martin is a big boy, he should pay him his the money that is being owed by his friend, that is a person of CDQ and the rest. But I think if true, I think that is not a good one from Burnaboy. That is one thing I believe about the whole thing. He should be matured in this kind of things. This is a small scandal and the rest. They can easily resolve this without making much or loud noise about that on social media. And CDQ is getting social about that. That is something I believe about the whole story, and I think he needs to keep that away from social media and then find a way to squash the beef with Burna Boy. That is something I believe about that. I need your comments in the comment section below about this thing I'm talking about right now. Yes, O'Malley has shared a crazy experience with a female fan. That is something trending on social media. He did that on a live interview and said something, and a lot of people were like, man, this is actually funny. According to him, he said a female fan knocked at his door at, you know, around 3 a.m. in the morning, and then that is actually crazy. And I think we're gonna allow these people to actually have their time to themselves, because they need to keep their hair straight and then make good music for us to enjoy. You know, we know that you are a fan, but doing those kind of crazy things, spark some other things within them, and I think those are distractions so far.
I could tell the craziest experience I've had from a female fan, and that was back when I my previous apartment. Somebody tailed me down to my house, got through my gate by about 3 a.m. in the morning, knocked my door for a photo. That's the craziest I've had, bro.
What can you make out of that? What can you actually, you know, put down in the comment section about what O'Malley has said so far? And I believe that, yes, that is not too cool at this point in time.
All the way, Love Cycle Remix.
Love Cycle Remix, trending right now on social media, is Davido and Anissa. Davido is in US, you know, want to shoot a music video of Love Cycle Remix. Yeah, Davido actually trended this artist, you know, when she asked a question, who do Nigerians want to be on the Love Cycle Remix? And Davido, you know, they selected Davido, and that made Davido to pop her on, you know, Twitter, and she gained a lot of followers on Twitter, and she's been so excited about. According to the report that made around, is that yes, she did supported Davido and other Nigerians or Nigerian youths during the NSAS protest, and that is why they are paying back right now. Davido in US, you know, having a music video with this lady, and she was all excited seeing the video in US, and she did made video of that, posted it on social media. A lot of people are reacting to that, and that the video is saying it joke. Guys, what do we expect, or what can we expect from Davido at this point in time? Do we expect the best from Davido? That is something I'm asking at this particular time, because we need to actually understand that when it comes to remix, Davido is also good. When it comes to remix, that is something he has not paid. And I like Wizkid when it comes to remix also, and we have to respect that. And these guys, they've done well enough to uplift the standard of Niger music across the global scene, and that is a kudos to Wizkid, Davido and Burna Boy. What do you have to say about these young men? They are rich, they are talented, they are handsome, and they got a lot of things that, you know, people, especially ladies, want. Before I jump off, I want you guys to kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, hit the subscribe button below and the bell notification icon to always get notifications each time I upload my videos. But if already subscribed, thank you for subscribing, and make sure you share my videos across all social media platforms so that others will get to see what is trending and what we are talking about as a people on social media. And don't forget to drop your comments in the comment section below so that we can talk about it further.